بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد، فنواصل معكم في هذا اليوم العظيم، في هذا اليوم المبارك، مستفيدين ومتعلمين اللغة العربية، اللغة العربية. So we continue, إخوان, in this blessed and noble day of ours, benefiting from, learning together from the science of the Arabic language. فوصلنا بحمد الله إلى صفحة 37. 37. So for those that have the book, then we have arrived at page number 37. صفحة 37. Page number 37. قال المؤلف حفظه الله تعالى. So the author continues. May Allah preserve him. قال ثامنا. As for the eighth exercise. املا الفراغات املا الفراغات في الجمل الآتية باختيار الكلمة المناسبة مما يلي. So the author continues. He says, fill in the blanks from the following sentences. He says, fill in the blanks from the following sentences بإختيار الكلمة المناسبة. He says, by choosing the suitable words. By choosing the suitable words. قال سرور. سرور is a bit. سرور is a bit. أو عفوا. سرور ليس سرير. سرور is happiness, afwan, or delight. بكل سرور. سرور is happiness or delight. سرور. طيب. سرور. سرور is happiness or joy, delight. Happiness, or you can say joy or delight. اتجه يتجه. اتجه to face or to go towards. It should be kasra. Ittajiha or ittajaha. No, should be fatha. اتجه. اتجه to face, to turn towards. No. Or you can say to go towards. اتجهها. طيب. طيب. سمحت. سمحت. From the verb سمح. سمح to allow. سمح. To allow. Or he allowed. سمح. To authorize, to give permission. سمح. يسمح. سمح. طيب هنا قال المؤلف سمحت. So in this exercise the author uses the verb سمحت connected with the تاء الفاعل. سمحت. You have allowed. سمحت. سمحت. والميزان. Well, here I believe it's لعله الميزاني. الميزاني. في هذا التمرين. In this exercise, لعله مجرور. Perhaps it is genitive. No. الميزان. The scale or the measuring scale. وآخر كلمة ملأ. ملأ. And the last word is the verb ملأ. To fill out, to complete. ملأ. To fill. To fill up, to fill. ملأ. 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 طيب سرور. happiness. joy. delight. اتجه. to face. to turn towards. to go towards. سمحت. you have allowed. الميزان, the scale. ملأ, to fill or to complete. الأولى, sentence number one. وضع المسافر الحقيبة على الفراغ. The traveler placed or put the bag upon الميزان. Upon الميزان. الجواب الأول الميزان. Sentence number one الميزان. الثانية sentence number two. الفراق blank. المسافر إلى بهو صالة السفر blank. The traveler towards or to the hallway of travel. اتجه المسافر إلى بهو السفر. The traveler went towards or turned towards the hallway of traveling. The hallway of traveling. الثالثة number three. طلب الموظف البطاقة فقال للمسافر البطاقة لو الفراغ. He says the official requested the card. So he said to the traveler البطاقة لو سمحت. He said to the traveler your card if you will, if you allow. البطاقة لو سمحت. وكلمة طلب بمعنى to request. To request. And the verb طلب. طلب means to request. To ask. Can also mean to seek. To seek. To seek. طلب to request, to ask. To request or to ask. طلب محمد العلم. Muhammad requested or he sought after knowledge. طلب محمد العلم. Muhammad sought after knowledge. Muhammad sought knowledge. طلب to request. He's requesting it. He's seeking it. To seek. طلب محمد العلم. Muhammad sought knowledge. طلب to request. To seek. هو مثل سأل is like the verb سأل to ask. والفرق بين فاء وثم. الفرق بين فاء وثم. The difference between the word fa or the harf fa and thumma. Thumma. Al-faruqu bain al-fa wa thumma. The difference between the word between fa and thumma. طيب ما معنى فاء وما فرق بين الفاء وثم؟ What's the difference يا إخوان between فاء and ثم؟ Between فاء and ثم. مثلا أقول لكم صليت العصر. صليت العصر ثم المغرب. ثم المغرب. طيب. If we were to say to you for example مثلا صليت العصر ثم المغرب. So we say صليت العصر ثم المغرب. طيب وفي الثانية in the second sentence صليت العصر ف المغرب. ما فرق بينهما؟ طيب we were to say in the second example صليت العصر فالمغرب. غيرنا ثم إلى الفاء. All we did was change the ثم صليت العصر ثم المغرب. So all we're doing here is changing the thumma to the fa. صليت العصر في المغرب. طيب جملتان مختلفتان. جملتان مختلفتان. Two different sentences. Two different sentences. طيب الآن صليت العصر ثم العصر. في الأولى in the first sentence I prayed عصر, then I prayed مغرب. I prayed عصر, then I prayed مغرب. I prayed عصر, and then I prayed مغرب. طيب أي أن المغرب جاء بعد العصر وبينهما الوقت. بينهما الوقت meaning I prayed عصر and then some time passed and then I prayed عصر. الله أعلم كم وقتا فات. Only Allah knows how much time passed. ولكن حصل بينهما الوقت. But some time passed. Not right after Asr, I pray Maghrib. Because thumma yufidu al-tarakhi. Thumma shows that some time passed. So I prayed Asr, then, not right after, I prayed Asr, then some time passed, and then I prayed Maghrib. Hadha bima'na thumma. That's the meaning of thumma. طيب وفي الثانية in the second example صليت العصر فالمغربا فالمغربا. الآن عندنا فا. Now we have the فا. فا. طيب صليت العصر فالمغرب. I prayed عصر فالمغرب. والفا مختلف ومختلفة من ثم. There's a difference between فا and ثم. طيب so now I pray Asr, then immediately after I pray Maghrib. هذا الفرق بين الفاء والثم. This is the difference between فاء and ثم. فاء مباشرة or ba'dahu mubasharatan. Fa means immediately right after that, then this took place. وهذا يدل على دقة هذه اللغة أي اللغة العربية. And this shows the accuracy and the precision of the Arabic language. ثم and fa. طيب مثال آخر. Another example. Another example. ورأيت الشيخ وطالبه. طيب نكبر هذا. We'll make this bigger for your brothers that are logged on. You can see the notes. You can see the screen. طيب رأيت الشيخ وطالبه. طيب I saw should be a W. I saw the sheikh and his student. من طالبه؟ الله أعلم. Who is his student? Allah knows best. لا يذكر. It's not mentioned. لا يذكر. طيب. رأيت الشيخ وطالبه. I saw the sheikh and his student. عفوا. This should be ثم. رأيت الشيخ ثم. نعم هذا هو. رأيت الشيخ I saw the sheikh ثم طالبه. Then I saw his student. ليس مباشرة بعد أن نظرت إليه وبعد أن رأيته. لا جاء نظري إلى طالبه بعد ذلك. الوقت حصل بينهم. الوقت حصل بينهم. Here, since we use ثم, it doesn't mean right after I saw the sheikh, I saw his student. No, some time passed. الله أعلم كم وقتا. Only Allah knows how much time passed. ولكن باستخدام ثم عرفنا أن الوقت قد حصل بينهما. But since we use ثم, I saw the sheikh, then his student. So you don't know how much time passed, but some time passed. رأيت الشيخ ثم طالبه. I saw the sheikh, then I saw his student. How much time passed? Allah أعلم. That's not the point. However, نظري إلى الشيخ أو نظري إلى طالبه ما جاء مباشرة بعد أن رأيت أو بعد أن رأيت الشيخ. But me seeing the student of the sheikh did not come right after me seeing the sheikh. I saw the sheikh, then his student. طيب الآن رأيت الشيخ فطالبه. Now similar sentence. I saw the sheikh فطالبه. Now نغير ثم إلى الفاء. We're going to change ثم for the فاء. I saw the sheikh فطالبه. And immediately right after I saw the sheikh, I saw the student or his student. Allahu Akbar. طيب. I saw the sheikh and then immediately after I saw his student. وهذا يدل على دقة اللغة العربية. And once again, this shows the precision and the accuracy of the Arabic language. مثال آخر, another example. قوله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم. الله تعالى says قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. هذه المثال سيدلنا إلى دقة هذه اللغة. This example, once again, is going to show the precision and the accuracy وأهمية تعليم هذه اللغة and the importance of studying the Arabic language. Allah Ta'ala says, قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. طيب سنركز على الواو. Now we're going to focus on the واو. سنركز على الواو. طيب كثير من المترجمين من المسلمين الآن يقولون, many of the translators and the Muslims in general, they have said that Allah Ta'ala says in this ayah, save yourselves, and then after you save yourselves, you go back and save your families. وهذا خطأ. And that's a mistake. Some brothers say, there it is. Allah Ta'ala said it first. قو أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. Save yourselves, and then after you're safe, you go back and save your families. هذا خطأ. That's a grave mistake. ويدل على أهمية تعليم هذه اللغة. And it shows the importance of studying this language. بدون تعليمنا اللغة العربية سنخطئ كثيرا في العقيدة وسنخطئ كثيرا في الحديث وسنخطئ كثيرا في التفسير وسنخطئ كثيرا في الفقه وفي اللغة وفي الفهم. Without studying the Arabic language, we're going to make many mistakes in the science of belief. Without studying the Arabic language, we're going to make many mistakes in the science of al-hadith. Without studying the Arabic language, we're going to make many mistakes in tafsir, in al-fiqh, especially, and in the Arabic language. فنركز على الواو. So we're going to focus on the waw. Al-waw la yadullu ala tartib. The waw. Al-waw. Al-waw. The waw in the Arabic language, ya ikhwan, la yadullu ala tartib. The waw has nothing to do with order. And the people of the Arab, or to the Arab people, in the Arabic language, the waw la yufidu at-tartib. The waw, write this down, ya ikhwan, a tremendous benefit. The waw has nothing to do with ordering or order. The waw does not give the benefit like thumma and fa. Thumma yufidu tartib, wal waw yufidu tartib biduni taraqi. Thumma gives order, but some time comes, and fa shows order without time passing. The waw khilafuhuma. The waw is different. The waw is different than thumma and fa. Al waw la yufidu at-tartib. The waw does not give the benefit of order. The waw does not benefit order. The waw does not give the benefit of order. Has nothing to do with order or arrangement. Al-waw yadullu ala musharikati al-fi'l. All the waw does is show that the thing participates with the other thing in whatever the verb says. That's it. So huna qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. So when Allah Ta'ala says, save yourselves and your families. Alwa yadullu ala musharakati anfusina wa ahlina. So the waw is showing that you saving your, or us saving ourselves and our families are connected. They participate together. Not you save your families first, not you save yourself first, and then when you're safe, you go back and save your family. لا. أنت تستيقظ مثلا في الصلاة أو في الصباح لتصلي الفجر فأنت تصلي الفجر ثم تيقظ أهلكم. لا هذا خطأ. So you wake up in the morning and you offer your salah, and then after your salah is complete, you wake up your family, save yourselves, and then when you're safe, go back and save your family. لا. Save yourself, you wake up, you wake your family up. You wake up for the prayer, you wake your family up for the prayer. طيب. وكل هذه الأمثلة تدل على أهمية اللغة العربية. And all of these examples, and other than that, show the precision and the accuracy of studying the Arabic language. طيب. قال المؤلف. The author continues. الرابعة. Sentence number four. رد المسافر فقال بكل سرور. بكل سرور. So the traveler replies. فقال. There's that fa again. He replies. فقال. And he said, or then he said, بكل سرور. With all happiness. With all delight. بكل سرور. بكل سرور. بكل سرور. بكل سرور. With all happiness, all delight. With all delight. بكل سرور. طيب الخامسة. Number five. blank المسافر البطاقة ملأ المسافر البطاقة the traveler filled out the card البطاقة ملأ to fill طيب إن شاء الله تعالى نكتفي بهذا ونواصل في الدرس الرابع so we'll stop there يا إخوان we'll continue إن شاء الله in the next lesson with الدرس الرابع class or lesson number 4 اقرأ read طيب لأصحاب الكتب فنحن على صفحة 38 for those that have the book then we have arrived at page number 38 page number 38 وجزاكم الله خيرا فنسبت فمن الله وانا اخطأت من نفسي anything that we said that's correct is from our Lord anything that we said that's incorrect is from ourselves وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته